Hello everyone, my name is Snowy Frosty. Today I'm gonna play Life is Strange Before the Storm, Farewell. This is the last episode of Life is Strange Before the Storm. It's not only the last episode because it's bonus. So, let's go. Life is Strange Farewell will be about Chloe and Max Caulfield when they were young. It's really good to see them, you know, again.
Ready? I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak?
She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
What are you doing? I mean, nice protection. Holy Jesus. Well, I guess that's what.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen! That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Yeah, sure. Why not, Light?
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now.
I never had this experience, you know.
In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. How do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Max, I totally understand you. Life is Strange Before the Storm, bonus episode, Farewell.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look.
I'm kinda serious about you guys because
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures.
You know, my family is really stish about everything.
What's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
It sounds later.
Freaking out when she got this letter.
Two plans of Chloe flies, dear parents. Congratulations, you shy Chloe flies happy later. 10th, 4th, September 2008. Admission to Blackwell Academy. We have offered place of approximately 100 students out of 1,200. Applicant, you shall excel In our fire mission, and we look forward to welcoming you and Chloe to the Backwave Academy family. Marco is gone, says this. Okay.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Was everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Oh, the best is the plan too. Is wasn't in this place, isn't it?
It's so hard to believe. This room, this house, this town. All in the past now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Man, I get goosebumps because of this song. Ugh, I love it. Let's see.
Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
No way.
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
No way I'm gonna damn this stuff. Please.
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bear. Whoa. Talk about embarrassing. How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Okay, you say so. Oh, right, I still did not talk to Chloe yet. Let's say.
Why is getting rid of stuff so much harder than collecting it?
Maybe because you're an overly sentimental hoarder?
Granted. But I still need some more junk in the trash pile.
Because you have memory with it?
Chloe's such why. A nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies. Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away.
Memory is always hard to forget, especially if they are super bad or super happy. Super good, I mean. Oh, it's y'all, beggar.
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
Wait, what? Doesn't it expire somehow?
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker?
serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
Come on.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Wow, you saw in that? What? I would never lick that again.
That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure?
What are you...
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine. It's filled with holes and falling apart.
That never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
Man. No, I wouldn't.
You better not be thinking what I think.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Yeah,
totally understand.
Totally understand. Yeah.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
Oh, right. What about this one?
This seems like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
If you say so. Yeah, I guess we won't throw away anything today.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two under-supervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
The last memory.
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Tell her now, because you won't be able to tell
Actually,
her later.
Chloe, I really have to tell you something. It's... I... don't know how
Holy
to...
shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here.
What's that?
Do you have any idea
Ooh,
what this is?
It's a sensei.
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out? You're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
my eyes spot two fair pirate witches.
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project!
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
Alright, alright. Supper's in 5. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame.
As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And... bye.
Dude, that was...
hilarious. We were so, so ridiculous.
We still are, Max. We still are. Okay, okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting.
Okay, then. Maybe you'll say so.
I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Mail Silver. Whoa. Poco! What? Pilot's low. No bad thing, no boat to the ship, no shelling pilot's secret, always share plunder, always belly treasure, always protect fellow pilot. Failure to obey this low will be resulted in plank walking. Captain's log, another day of plunder and destruction on the seas. Old Baratasha has come under attack again. The evil commander Shelley, enemy to all pilots, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wants to steal it from us. We are doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it, because our enemy wants our treasure so bad. We must make sure the map is only readable to us, Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. To Plumber and Leashes.
This looks like a page was ripped out.
Oh.
I wonder if it's the map.
It surely is. I bet.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map.
Hmm.
But where could it be? Any luck?
Nope. You?
Nothing yet.
The map, eh? Oh, light.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott
family,
but
oh, Prescott Foundation
pretty cool.
Again. What's that? Max and Chloe, Silver Adventure. You, Max and Chloe, best friends of Sudan in school, you sit in class and see Sudan in the kills when you're alive. You are very stupid, brave. You leap down into a silver. Thankfully, there is pile of dust when I peel and dirty divers to land on. Pew! You hear squirrely sounds in the distance, so you learn to follow it. There are many twists and turns. Eventually, you come to a fork in the road. But now's not the time for eating. So you put the fork back down and consider the two paths in front of you. On the ground, you see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of sealed up paper to the right. Which way do you go? Left page 9, right page 7. Oh, okay. Let's go with busy. Why don't you like squirrel? They are so cute and nice. You must be really mean. The squirrel seemed annoyed that you ignored her. She lands in and steals the book report light off your dress. Then run back outside. The squirrel stole my book report. You tell to the teacher. Uh-huh, whatever you say. Mrs. Ander Lisbon, clearly not believing you. What do you do? Share the squirrel, pitiful. Stay in class, pitten. Pitiful, as soon as Mrs. Ander turn around, you run out of the window and shoot the squirrel. And share the squirrel, sorry. That is a really bad thing to do, and you hope you did get, you hope you don't get in trouble later, but you probably will. Outside you look around, but you can't find Squirrel. Is she gone? Oh, there she is. She's standing next to the sewer hole. You run up to her, but she gets scared and jumps down. Oh boy. Do you really want to go down there? Page 5. You run away like scaredy cat. I don't blame you, that thing is gone. As you run and you almost trip on a shiny object, you pick it up, it's a lighter. Your mom never play you with this, but she's not here right now, is she? Now is your chance to kill the king lad and protect all the students' homework once and for all. This is your last chance to be a hero. Will you do it? Just kidding, you didn't get a choice. You may choose to do something, but I'm still out of here. You have to attack the lad king, but how do you want to attack him? Burn his tail, page 11. Burn his thorn, page 13. Page 6. I don't blame you, that silver looks pretty scary, but is there any way other down? Sorry, but is there any other way down? Suddenly, a light bulb appears above your head. You use this to light the way back to your house and into your bathroom. You step on one foot into the toilet and whoosh, whoosh. Next thing you know, you are in the sewer on the ground. You see the tail of tiny footprint to the left, and you see the sewer paper to the right. Where do you go? Left page 9, right page 7. Page 7, it's my choice. You choose to go the right, following the path of sewer paper. After a bit of walking, you end up in the dark corner. Suddenly, the fog fall away. You find yourself swimming in some sort of warm liquid, almost like a big puddle, except why does this liquid taste like corn? By the time, come on. It turns out you're not in the puddle, you're in the big bowl of corn soup. And all around you are squirrels, holding spoon and wearing tiny little aprons. They look so cute. And the soup keeps getting hotter. Guess you weren't too smart after all, actually you'll be delicious. The end. Page 8. You go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course, why wouldn't you? It's so cute. And you want to pet it. Hey, Mr. Squirrel, you say. Ah, stop biting me! You say next because the squirrel is now biting your hand. but it's too late. You have Lavis and Mrs. Anders had to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her really sad, girl. You shouldn't pet the squallow. Then, pet 9, you pick light. I mean left. Which what light? Is what confusing in the distance. You see Squallow, but he's not moving. In fact, oh sorry. What pair are we in again? In fact, he's dead. Who killed the poor Squallow? Suddenly, the ground began to shake. Around the corner, a giant light appeared. It's the biggest light you ever seen. The biggest anything you ever seen. It's the Light King. The Light King is wearing a crown and standing on the throne. Of all your missing homework, including your book report, what do you do? Learn towards it, page 12. Learn away, page 5. You decide not to share. Page 10. You decide not to share the squallow. When the time comes to send your book report, you tell Mrs. Anders that a squallow stole it and ran away. She doesn't believe you, remember? I told you she doesn't believe in you. Why didn't you listen? You should pay more attention. Anyway, Miss Anders reports you to the principal and as soon as you kick out of school for being bad student without school. You can never get a job or make money out now. You live in the shack without TV and two dogs. Is this you, Chloe? Soon, you will be dead. Guess you should have paid more attention. How many pages is this? Oh. Okay. You decide to burn his long hairy tail. Good plan. Whoosh. The king's last tail is on fire. She does not like that a one bit. He started freaking out, waving his tail around like Cassie. You know all the trash and dirty diaper in the sewer. Those are highly inflammable, which means the same as flammable for some reason. Suddenly, the entire sewer catches on fire. You're surrounded by gas silver flames. Is this really how you die? Burning into the fire, burning to death with fire light king in disgusting silver. Get it, yes. At the end. Pair 12. Your dad always tell you to learn towards problem, but not away from them. Unfortunately, you pick a really bad time to listening to him. You learned light toward the Light King. At first, he seemed surprised, but you tried to punch him in the face, but you forgot forget about his long hairy ghost tail. He robbed you like a boa constrictor and dub you into his mouth, swallowing you with one grub. Now you get to see what's inside the lens look like. This would make a great science report. Too bad you won't be alive to tell anyone else at the end. Pesos in, you decide to burn the Light King stone. It hurts you to burn all that amazing homework, including your wonderful book report, but remember, that is for a good reason. As soon as the stone catches on fire, the Light King screaming, "Oh no, my son!" Suddenly, the Light King begins to shrink. Before long, he is back to size up. No more left. He can't even climb out. He was calm. Oh, he's so cute now. You land back to the class and tell Mrs. Sanders about Lad King and everything happened. Not only she forgive you for not having the book report, but she declares that you are the guestest hero in the school. Duh. The end. Until the next Max Clay adventure. Oh my god, I have headache reading that. This is so inventive. Maxine and Chloe, but next time, please do the boogly part you assigned, Mrs. Sanders.
Oh, yes! Take that, Rack. Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude.
But I can't even post with Chloe. Of course, but it's Chloe. How was it?
And photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try.
No, I don't have it yet. Where could it be? What are we doing again? Oh, nice. The map.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in the
social studies.
I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year.
Good job, as always, Chloe. Now please, try to pay attention in class instead of drawing picture with Maxine. Where could it be? Oh. What's he said? The map. Chloe's secret lair, treasure land, dark heaven, amulet, black castle. Oh man, the songs.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? We need the telescope and the amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
It was. Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
Okay.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later.
Another dollar to sweat
this
up.
This has to be my last day here. Might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Okay, you say so. pressure.
Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
Mina can fix that and you. Wow.
Chloe's parents are so cute. The two whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close.
Wow, what's that?
It's so sweet that Chloe's mom takes this photo with her to work.
Nicotine gum.
Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking.
She go quit garment check until back.
Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier.
Yeah, I say.
The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about.
Hello, Mrs. Anne. Mr. Price. I would like to begin by saying we are thrilled to have Chloe at Blackwell. Let's assure, her scholarship is not jeopardized at this time. However, it seems that she is having trouble transitioning into this new, more challenging environment. I'm emailing to set up a time to talk about the incident that occurred last week. I'm really concerned about Chloe's behavior and would like to work with you to take steps to correct it as soon as possible. I'm sure you are as dedicated to Chloe's success as we are. The future needs excellence.
Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her.
Lay, Chloe was not the only student to act out that day. Yeah, and if you ask me, Marissa Lothar isn't the victim, she's the bully. Maybe if both sides of the story were heard before placing the blame, your school would be less challenging environment for your students. Focus on your school. I will focus on my daughter, William Price.
I wonder if it's still there.
These type of people are exactly why I didn't want Chloe at Blackwell. We'll figure this out, I promise. I love you too. Subject appointment to you. I forgot to tell Mrs. Lozo called why we're out yesterday and left a message. It's still on the answering machine, but please really be careful when you listen it. I don't want Chloe to overhear. We need to figure out how to handle this. I know the principal said her scholarship is in danger, but I still worry.
Sometimes I really wish I had siblings.
Ellen, please! Finally, use your pleasure washer today. And I just want to say thank you again for letting me borrow. It works like sham. It's not all steam house, but now it can at least be the light color. If you want to come over next week and give me a hand, there will be a cold beer in it for you. Give me a call. Hope everything at work is still going well, and tell the night say hello. Pentagon.
Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip.
Portland.
Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so, Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it.
Except that did not go.
No strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it. I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation. I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
Okay, I guess I better get everything.
I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer.
Well, it's not your home.
Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it.
No, to tell you.
I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years.
Well, I mean, don't cry because it ends. Cry because it's heaven. Remember all the good times, not the bad ones.
There it is, the dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on.
I think
I'm sure
I see it.
Something around here to boost me up.
Great. Done. Not work.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
Something. Too bad that wouldn't work. Would it?
Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
I think I see it. Yeah.
Just need a few more inches.
Few more inches. Anything in here? No. A few more inches.
Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last scheme we ever plan here.
Oh, it is in that room. I cannot say anything.
I just need a few more inches to reach the attic.
Oh, the book.
I think that should be tall enough.
I wanna look at the window first.
I wonder if I'll ever take this view in again.
Sure, Max. You will be. For sure. Not as soon, but... four to... five, dear? You're about 14, right? So, yeah, about 4 to 5 here. Spider!
There's a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is.
An amulet.
Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through. I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time. Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from. I think I can squeeze through now. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kinda difficult.
Oh, fish tank.
I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute.
What if we've pulled these clothes?
One step closer.
Can they go now? Nope. Wait, what?
This desk's pretty.
Why would I push that? Yeah. Okay. Oh.
Glad this thing is empty.
What's in there? An amulet.
Finally. A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
What you doing? Wow.
Chloe Price. My best friend.
Calvin.
It's so weird being back in his attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about.
Yeah, that's kinda
and
too.
By spiders. I'm gonna miss her.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend. That's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Find the amulet?
Hell yeah.
Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way. No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. Oh, I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
Oh. Damn.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Land ho.
Perfect.
Hey, man. Explore first.
I still wish I could live in the world we drew. I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now.
Wait just a minute.
Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Grrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on.
Thanks, Max.
I think I saw a tape.
Time to stick the amulet to the telescope. Then that treasure is ours.
I think I saw a tape. Oh.
I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving?
It's not really selfish. You will never see anything come back, you know.
Bro. Don't you mean sis?
Actually, I meant dweeb.
Dork.
Punk.
Punks are cool.
Because you are cool.
You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
Damn right. About time you realized it.
Tell anyone and I'll deny it. Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying.
Right. I think it's all tape, right?
This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something.
Oh, it is.
Score! One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is. If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Yeah, totally. But we're losers together.
If you're a loser, Max, I don't think I want to be cool. It's just... this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the Seven Seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Come, Max. Remember how we used to
talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day. I thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates. Hell yeah.
Now let's see if it's worth. Oh, it probably is. Yep.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver? Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Let's see, Yimak. What can we find?
Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something?
Here goes nothing. Okay. Let's see. The drawing is supposed to line up with something.
I think this is a pole. Yeah?
Got it.
Light.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Your left.
Okay, take a step left.
No, I mean your left.
Wrong way.
You said left.
Your other left. Go the other way.
The other way to my other left?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me.
Yep. That's about it.
Bingo.
Let's see. Summon.
What the?
That is not what we buried.
Let's see if what's in it. Mighty ye
oh
back. I don't know.
Bro beard, let's sorry. Open. From the Bloody Bill.
From Bloody Bill? Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Probably.
Aha.
Yeah.
Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Lame.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given an extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scroped, and always remember, the real treasure is
friendship,
love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Of course.
Ugh.
Ugh, lame. Lame, such a lame.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Yes,
holy
I.
Crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Dear Chloe, how are you today? I'm doing very well. It is Friday, June 27, 2003. It is summer vacation. We are making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We are making it pilot theme. Wasn't it hell of a fine? These are something we like. One, we favorite animal. Elephant house. Other Chloe. Favorite food, lobster low, Max. I have the ice cream, Chloe. Favorite class, Chloe. Art or library, Max. Science, Chloe. Best friend, each other, both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite food, movie, etc.? That's all for now. I hope you're having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best. Sadly, Max Saint Clothing.
How about mine? What did I write?
Essay.
This is so Chloe.
Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here's a record of how we spend our day together. We spend our days. Can you guess which one is Leah? We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. Duh! We have sleepover at least once a week. We like extremely salty pleasure. We are in list to see who can convince your family to get a pet first. We are going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. We have battles, many foes, and no fail to save each other. What is your guess? If you guess all of them, you are like your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price.
You were really sweet.
Oh man, that was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at. Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Just dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything.
Yeah,
this container
you have time.
Looks like it could last 100 years.
No time in the world.
This looks like the punchline to something. Where's the rest?
It's looking really good. Is this an insect or something?
These are awesome.
The shopper.
Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
Frame fingers. Frame and stone. This could be really dangerous and really cool. Lace of sunshine. Suns are here. Sunlight here, so boom. Wow. Pretty cool to be honest. Prediction for future by Chloe and
Maxine. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
We still hang out with each other more than anyone, any person. Both of us are medium popular. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. What's that mean? We do not make decisions without consulting each other. The taking scout of our enemy. Both of us have a pit. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could live calm if she wants. One of us has a little sister on Plato. We are doing well in school. That's not really accurate.
It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. Is writing once a week too often? Will I run out of things to say? These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do. Lupin!
Lupin, let's see. Sorry for children from around the world.
Keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art.
You see that? Did you say that? Wow! Wow!
We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing we're close to.
That is some cool chat Easter egg. I saw the butterfly. That's mean. We're back in this time. Partner in time. Maybe Maxine did just rewind the time. Interesting.
There. Now you've got something pretty to look.
Clean.
Much better. I always look especially sharp next to Chloe.
Oh, this peak. Oh, this mean that William just got out because we just make pancake, right? Or something. And Joyce calling.
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Good luck, Happy. We are so proud of your promotion. You get a week. Yep, for sure. She just got out.
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic. Chloe and I have been friends for so long.
So cute.
Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things.
I love this one. This one is so cute.
I guess I should try talking to Chloe again about my news. I can do that after I've finished looking at everything. Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance. Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Let's see, what Chloe, you know, down.
You're such a space hog. Move over.
What, you down?
Nope.
Let me see. I'm gonna see you too, Chloe. We're too down. I wanna say too. Let me see. Let me see.
You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this. Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yep.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
What's that?
This is so silly.
Jeez, this jawbreaker is gonna last forever.
This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She didn't
you should tell her.
Want to talk about anything serious
you
upstairs.
You should not save any ticket to yourself.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
Nah. Tell her.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
Tell her you might not get a chance to tell her later.
So yeah.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
It's
Max,
okay.
I said it was okay.
Yeah.
I was
it's okay.
Trying to tell you this morning, but...
But I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know?
Yeah, useless time is precious.
I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Partner in time. Oh. Partner in class. Oh no! The sun! Jesus! What? The sun? I thought it would be sooner.
Mom?
Black flies on the window sill.
What the
f- we are, that we are, that we are.
You did not. You don't have to hit me, did you did not have to hit me this hard and fast.
A darkened plumed estate.
Jesus.
Hope your needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place.
You did not have to hit me this hard. Why do you hit me so hard and fast? I don't understand.
No man is an island. For this I know. But can't you see? Oh, well, maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone.
William, ish,
like. We are the whole. Comfort came against my will. And every story must grow old. Still I be a traveler. A gypsy's reins to face. But the road is weary. With that fool found in your place. No man is an island, for this I know. But can't you see, oh, maybe you were the ocean when I was just a storm.
Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if I never... Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
You did not hit me that hard, Dick Nine. My God. Sorry, it would be you know, sooner than this. Ah. Anyways, that is Life is Strange. Before the storm, farewell. I hope you guys enjoyed. Remember that to take care of yourself. And hope this guy is doing well. My name is Noi Forsey, and that is for today. See you again next time. I am out.